When streaming to YouTube, it is very helpful to match your stream rate out of your system, maybe OBS or vMix as an example, with the bit rate that YouTube is expecting. By default, it likes to use a variable bit rate, but I'm gonna show you how to fix that so it's a standard fixed bit rate so the quality of your video is consistent from start to end. Hi there, internet fans, Ryan Perry here, and I help business people and entrepreneurs like yourself harness the power of video in order to grow and build your business. So for this quick tutorial, we need to jump on YouTube, which is where I'm at right now, and we're specifically talking about live video. So there are a number of ways to get to live. I like to click on the create button in the upper right hand corner and click on the go live feature. Once you have this set, it will work wherever you want in here. I have actually created a stream called the Test for Training stream, so I'm going to go ahead and click on that. Where we're looking at specifically is going to be right here where it has the stream key, and there's a little pull down, a caret on the right hand side. If we click on that, we can actually create new stream keys and we can manage the stream keys that are already created. Now for me, I've already created them. I have one that's set up for a fixed rate at 720. I also have another one that's fixed for 1080. And then I have the default YouTube, which I've actually renamed to Do Not Use because I don't ever want to use this. So as an example, what you can do though is just go ahead and click on Create New Stream Key. So this is gonna be, let's just call this a 1080 test. As an example, you can add an additional description if you'd like to. We're going to leave all the settings here as far as RTMP. However, we are going to turn on the manual settings, and this is what's going to give us the ability to let YouTube know exactly what stream rate or bit rate we want to send to it. So for 1080, I'm going to go ahead and click the 1080p option here, and then just note for yourself that YouTube is recommending 3000 to 6000 kilobits per second. Once that's done, you also have an option here for 60 frames a second if you want, and then go ahead and create. Now, if I click on my list, I have my test here, but I also have my 720, my 1080, and my new one that I just created, my test one here. And what's really key about this is that if you are streaming on a regular basis, when you click on one of these stream keys, so as an example, if I click on the 720, this stream key is going to be the same stream key always for this one. So if I select this stream key, it's always going to be relevant to this 720 that I created. It will not change. Same thing, if I click on the 1080, whatever the stream key is now is going to be relevant to the 1080. The reason why I mention this is that if you've created a stream already, you come back in here and you create a new stream that you're going to manage. That, let's say you create one that's for 1080, so you're not dealing with variable bitrate. That means your key has changed. So you want to make sure within your program, maybe OBS or vMix as an example, that you change the stream rate there. Once you're done, you can go back and even if you're creating a new stream, so let me schedule a new stream as an example. I'm going to create a new one and we have to give it a name. Go ahead, create stream. And again, the same screen is going to pop up that allows us to select which stream key. Now you'll notice that by default, YouTube is going to their variable setting. I don't want that variable setting. If I'm going at 1080, I want to use my 1080. And again, this key, if you're able to store the key in software in OBS or vMix as an example, this key will always be the same. So I don't have to change those settings. So that's a benefit there. that's it. Real basic tutorial today on how to set up a stream key so that your software that you're streaming from, the bitrate, is constantly sending to YouTube, and YouTube is expecting this set bitrate so you don't get variables and fluctuations. As always, if you found this information helpful, we always appreciate a like on the video. If you have any questions, leave that below. And if you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell. Until next time, have a great day. And on the, if you have any questions or comment, be sure to leave them below. And of course, leave a like, comment, leave a like, comment, like, and